Hi, I'm Sam Ekstrom with Zone Coverage, and if I were calling the shots in this upcoming draft, here are the decisions that I would make. Vikings have picks number 22 and 25. While it's tempting to package those picks up and try to move up in the draft, I think the only time you want to make that kind of splash, and the cost is so expensive to make a big move up like that, is if you wanted to get a quarterback. And with the recent extension of Kirk Cousins, I just don't think you would make that drastic of a move to trade up in the draft for any other position. So I think generally speaking, you stay put. Do you need to trade back and acquire more picks? You already have 12. I don't think that's necessary. You've got plenty of draft capital to work with. I think at maximum, you trade up one or two spots if there's a player you covet that you feel is going to get snatched away from you. But at pick number 22, I would go after a cornerback. You've got multiple holes to fill at that position. I like CJ Henderson, the big corner out of Florida. He could be sort of the power forward, quote unquote, that you had with Xavier Rhodes, 6'1", 200 pounds, runs a 4.39 40. I like his physicality. Then at 25, a lot of fans want the Vikings to go receiver, but I think you can get great value at receiver in the second, third, or fourth round, maybe even former Gopher Tyler Johnson. I also like LaVisca Chenault if he drops to the second round. I think you build up the trenches with your second first round pick. Go after the best possible defensive lineman, AJ Epenesa out of Iowa, who plays off the edge, maybe the defensive tackle Javon Kinlaw out of South Carolina. I think if they fall in your lap, that's tempting. You've got to replace Everson Griffin. You've maybe got some room there at the three technique spot. Or if an offensive lineman falls in your lap, if Tristan Wirfs falls down the board, I'd consider it. Mekhi Becton out of Louisville, the mammoth tackle, I'd consider that too. I think you've got sort of a liberating flexibility here in that there are multiple areas where you can choose. You don't have to pigeonhole yourself at one position. You can go in the trenches, you can go at cornerback, and I think you can kind of let the board fall to you. You don't need to force anything. Just take the best player available.